Everybody, okay, happy Monday. What we're going to be doing this week is we are going to start making movie revisions on our movie review. So our first mini lesson is right here. So click on the mini lesson, you're going to click on this link. It's going to bring you to this new tab. So today what we're going to do, our goal is to identify the claim, evidence, and reasoning in your writing. So you guys need to go into your writing and you're going to make sure that you have your summary. Remember, summary is a quick description of the movie that you're talking about. So it talks about the characters, the problem in the story, the theme, the tone. And then we're going to move on to claim. So the claim is what the author, you, believes about the topic. So it's what you believe about this movie. Is it a movie people should watch? Is it a movie people should not watch? And then we're going to look at reasoning. So with our reasoning, we explain why the author, or you, believes the claim. Okay? So we have our summary of the movie. We have your claim, whether or not you think people should watch it, and then we have you explaining why you think people should or should not watch it. So we have an example, and I'll read through this example, and then we'll discuss the highlights. Most animated family funny movies use the same plot elements. The main characters have to overcome obstacles in pursuit of their goal or solving their problems. Most often, there's also a main bad guy to defeat. But what if the antagonist was the main character? Despicable Me is a perfect example of a family comedy animation that was rated certified fresh on Rotten Tomatoes with an 82% rating. Despicable Me is interesting to watch due to high quality humor and interesting characters, and of course the minions. In this film, it tells the story of a bad guy's gradual transformation into a loving father. Gru, voiced by Steve Carell, dreams of becoming the most famous criminal, but is burning with jealousy, caused by the success of his opponent, Vector, who managed to steal the Pyramid of Cheops, and Gru decides to steal the moon. In order to do this, he must continue to face his nemesis, Vector. With the help of his three newly adopted girls, he plans on using to sneak into Vector's lair. He does not know that this will change his entire evil genius career and give him a family he didn't even know he needed. Despicable Me is funny from the beginning and until the ending credits. There's a combination of funny adventures to bad jokes, from Steve Carell's terrible accent to the funny minions. You can't help but laugh at this film. The humor helps create balance between the criminal adventures and heartfelt family moments between Gru and his daughters. The creators managed to create realistic and interesting character types. A nasty-looking but kind Gru, open-hearted and clever girls, Margot, Edith, and Agnes, sinister Mr. Perkins, and the head of the bank of supervillains. The funny but impudent Vector, Dr. Nefario, delved into his research, and of course the minions. These help the audience to connect and believe the story being told. Though the plot is rather predictable, watching these characters interact and get out of funny situations is what makes Despicable Me such a perfect movie for the whole family. Okay, so we have our claim here at the top, and it's our writer's opinion that Despicable Me is interesting to watch, and then it gives the reasons due to high quality humor and interesting characters. Then we come down and we have a whole paragraph in which we've summarized the movie. So a summary, remember, doesn't have just a couple specific details. It's a general idea of what the movie was about. And then we have reasoning. So this is your reason why that movie is interesting. The humor helps create balance. And then these characters help the audience connect. So these are our reasons. We have our summary and our claim. So what you're going to do is you're going to go into your movie review draft, which is on slide 3, and highlight the following. If you don't have these elements, you need to make sure that you add them. So you're going to give a quick description of the plot, characters, conflict, themes. So give your summary. You're going to give your claim, what you believe about the topic, and then reasoning. Explain how the evidence supports the claim. You're going to click back into your slides. And you can click down here where it says number 2. You can click and it's going to take you. Oh, if it's slide 3 up here. Let me switch that for you. Slide 6. You are going to click over here. Slide 6, and this is where your rec draft will be, okay? Your rec draft information, of course, that you got from here. So, you're going to have 3 highlights. You're going to have your claim, your summary, and your reasoning. make sure you reference a video that's here to help you out. Make sure you ask questions if you have any. And we hope you have a great